I have developed this three-phase inverter, as you can see here. So we have this switch S1, S3, S5, and similarly we have three switches connected on the low side. For the gate driver circuit, we have developed this scheme here. So you can see we have this sinusoidal source available here, which then amplitude equals to 0.7. Notice that we have for the carrier waveform, the peak-to-peak voltage is equal to 2 volt, which means that if I may draw it here, this triangular waveform shall have a peak value on the positive side equal to 1 and the negative side equal to 1. And with this sine wave equals to 0.7, this database says that this M of A is equal to 0.7. So for the simulation process, this M of A is equal to 0.7, and that is set by putting the value of peak to peak voltage equal to 2 for this triangular waveform and 0.7 for a sinusoidal waveform. So we are expected to have an output frequency equal to 60 Hertz. Notice that for VA of for this VA reference, we do not have any phase angle and an associated phase shift. However, here we have included for with minus 120 degree again, because the operation should be a balance. Therefore, the other two waveforms are also set at amplitude equal to 0.7. An interesting thing here is that because we discussed that this MFF should be a multiple of 3, so we have because this value is equal to 60, so this MFF, which is equal to which is set at 9, therefore this V triangle is equal to 540 Hertz. It is set at 540 Hertz. Also, that we have now three comparators instead of having one comparator in as we saw for the single phase PWM inverters. This is actually a limiter that limits the values between 0 and 1 so that we get a proper gating signal for all the three legs of this particular three-phase inverter. Notice that this VA of A, we have used this label block to avoid unnecessary routing here. So this VA of A is connected with this switch S1, and through a NOT gate it is connected to switch number S4, and similarly the same thing have been done for this VB and VC. In addition to that, we have used a load that consists of a 10 ohm resistance in series with an inductance of 20 millihenry, and that is true for all the three loads. Load should be balanced, otherwise there will be harmonics in the output. So we have now we have set all the three values. We have set this amplitude equal to 100 volts. So we are actually transforming this 100 volt DC supply into a three-phase output. Notice that to measure the VA of N, we have used this voltage sensor. Also, we have a voltage sensor connected between these these two legs, which gives us a value equal to VA of B. So we are getting VA of B here. Also, we have connected an ammeter to probe the current through this A load, and we call it this I of A. So before we begin, let us have this simulation control. Let us check this thing. This is equal to 0.1. Total time is 0.1. So let me simulate this one. So now that we have simulated this thing, first of all, let us see what kind of carrier waveform and the reference waveform we have. So we have this VA reference, VB reference, VC reference, and this V carrier. Let us plot them all together here. So you can see here, let me change the color here of this V carrier, because this is difficult to see. So now you can see here that we have, let me show it for a few cycles. So this is VA of reference, and we have, this is VC of reference, and this is VB of reference, and this is the carrier waveform. So you can see here that the peak amplitudes of these sinusoidal waveform is set at 0.8, and for the carrier waveform it is equal to 1. So after that, let us see what kind of output we are getting at this particular point, that is the gating signal for switch S1. So for that, the probe is VA in A0. So let me draw that here. So you can see here, this is the VA0. Also, we need to plot VB0 and this is the VB0. And notice here that these were the same kind of results we have seen here. So this is VA0 and this is VB0. As far as this VAB is concerned, if I plot this VAB, then this VAB should look like this particular waveform, and this is exactly the same as we expected to as we expected here. The next thing we need to see is this VA of N. So VA of N is this kind of a voltage with the current I of A. So let us plot the two entities. So this is I of A and this is V A of naught. So if I plot it here, so you can see that this VA, sorry, this is not VA0, this should be VA of N. Okay, so now you can see here that this current is difficult to visualize. So let me get rid of this VA0 screen and this VB0 screen. So after that, we have deleted this thing. So let us also delete this VB0. So now you can see it is still not visible. So one way is that I actually provide it some shift by multiplying it with some value. Let us say it is equal to 20. So if I multiply it by 20, then we have quite a good waveform here. But just let to may have more clarity, let us change the color here to red and a little bit of line thickness. So that is the current that we witnessed in this particular section. So let us zoom this particular section to see if we are getting the same result as we analyzed in the theory. So you can see here, whenever we have a voltage applied, then we have a current which actually increases, and thereafter it decreases because these values are not exactly the same. Therefore, you can see here at this particular point, this slope is approximately zero when we do not have any voltage available. That is, VAN is equal to zero. In addition to that, we are more interested in seeing the harmonic spectrum here. So let me delete this particular graph here and see what kind of harmonic spectrum we expect for this VAB. So for that, let us take this FFT here. So you can see a lot of harmonic content is visible in this FFT. So let us say we restrict it to the place it equal to 1260 hertz. We get this type of a result here. So now you can see that we need to elaborate this this particular table here. Now, because this M of A is set to be equal to 0.7, therefore the fundamental component should have a value equal to 0.606, and because this VDC is equal to 100 volts, so therefore we expect to have 60 volt for the fundamental component. So if I move here, this is the fundamental component at 60 hertz frequency, and you can see that this VAB has 60.6 volt available. The next thing is that the next frequency component appears at M of F plus minus 2. This means that the next frequency should appear at be at F7, and thereafter the next element should be at F11. Now this F7 is actually a multiple of the fundamental frequency, 420 hertz, and this F11 should be equal to 16 to 11, that is equal to 660 hertz, and both should have an amplitude equals to 0.015 of the DC amplitude. This is the frequency at 420 hertz, which is the seventh component, and it is having 15 volt. So we are getting exactly what is elaborated in the table 8.8. That is how you can actually simulate these things to validate your results. Thank you very much.